Hello, I'm Canon EOS Photographer, Randall M. Rueff. Today is Monday, July 1st, 2013 AD. Happy birthday to my cousin, Laura Elizabeth Rueff, who is a doctor doing her radiology stuff, wherever she's doing it. But today I want to talk to you about in this video is the reported release of the Canon 1DS or 1D 3D or we don't know what it's called. But it's the 46.1 megapixel DSLR that everybody's talking about. Or a lot of people are speculating about and wanting, and I would love to have one. This is my Digital Rebel XT. I would love to replace this with a 1DX. I've been on the internet, and I've come across several blogs and several rumors, and some of them are substantiated, some of them aren't. Okay, here's what we got so far. 46.1 megapixels. A new sensor. A new high, or not high, but a new ISO capability. $9,000. They're saying this is either the 3D, or the 1S, or the 1D XS. Put a little Freudian slip on it. Or not Freudian slip, but Freudian twist to it, you know. XS, as it's too much. Either price-wise or capability-wise. But that's never the case. There's no such thing as too much. So excess would be something good. At least in my opinion. So whatever they're going to call this thing, like I said, the rumors are $9,000, a new and better sensor than the 1DX with a better and higher ISO capability. The 1DX has awesome ISO capability. My Digital Rebel XT right here goes to 1600. 100 to 1600. That's all this baby does. It's a good camera, but from back in the day. Still, it's what I use. It's a good camera. But I would love to get my hands on this, this new camera. So, Canon, if you're out there listening, I'm ready to unbox it. I'm ready to use it. I'm ready to show the world and tell the world about the greatness of your ever expanding technology. That's me, Canon EOS Photographer around the roof. And so, let's see what else. We got the $9,000 price point. Theoretical, new high ISO, which like I said, again, beating out the 1DX, which already has a super duper wow. So, I mean, anything they can do is going to be great. Let's see what else we got. I'm trying to think of what else. The same form factor as the 1DX or 1DC. So, basically, it's going to be the top of the line. It's not going to have where you have to put a battery grip or anything like that extra. It's going to be the 1DX form factor. Maybe a little bit bigger, maybe a little bit smaller. We don't know. But basically, the same thing. And that's basically the news. Now, here's some things I want Canon to do, and I'm hoping they're going to do. And that is internal GPS. That's right, GPS internal. We don't want to have to stick GPS devices either on top, on the flash mount, or on the side. We don't want that. It's good that we can do it with the 1DX and the 1DC and the 5D Mark III, but we want it built in, okay? Internal GPS. Secondly, they also have a Wi-Fi connector that you can screw on, just like the GPS that you can screw on. That would be great if that could be internal as well. Now, that's not something I personally would use, but there are a lot of people who would. And quite frankly, if I had it, I might use it. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I mean, depending on how fast it was. I mean, how fast is it going to be compared to a wired LAN? I don't know. Using Ethernet? I don't know. But if it would be great, and I'm just saying this would be great, if I could take my camera wirelessly with built-in capabilities and go straight from my camera to my iMac, that would be awesome, okay? And I'm sure it would work great with PCs too, but I'm not going there. Love them. I love my Mac. Need a new one? Need an upgrade, but besides that, it's great. But, so that would be great too. I'm just throwing that out there. The GPS capabilities are awesome, what they can do with it. Again, just we want it built in. We don't have to put a little device in there that, it's kind of a cumbersome hassle. Although, what they could do, just throwing out another idea for you guys at Canon, put a little GPS receiver into your flashes. Oh, there's another idea. Like your 600RT, put a little GPS. I mean, I can't imagine it would make it maybe a little, you know, fourth of an inch taller, or maybe a half inch taller, or even less. I don't know. But you can put a GPS receiver in there in the flash, and or make a combination flash GPS that wouldn't even have to be as big as the 600RT. That could, you know, work just as well. But my idea is to put it in the camera, because that way you always have it in the camera. And, I mean, that's what people want. Now, I know this is a little unprofessional, is the word. But, and I know they're probably 95% chance they're not going to do it. But, we would like a built-in flash. That's right, a built-in flash. Now, knowing it's not going to be, let me rephrase that. I want a built-in flash on a pro camera with a very simple on-off switch. Say this is my, let's imagine that my Digital Black C is a professional DSLR instead of a prosumer. The pop-up flash, okay. When I'm talking about professional flash, I want to be able to do this, and then just have a little button right here, on and off, on and off. Okay, so that it's easy to turn on and off. And another thing you might think about, now this is just me, I know there are, instead of a traditional flash, you could put like, oh, I don't know, a bright LED or a bright, something that can recharge a lot. I mean, it's not going to be as powerful, but would recycle it as fast as the frames per the frame rate. So this right here isn't going to recycle. I mean, I can shoot more pictures, and this won't be recycled as fast as all those pictures. This shoots 3 frames per second. Now I can shoot 3 frames depending on my card for, you know, for a while before it has to start, you know, lags because of the processor. But my point is, I can shoot a lot. Let's say I can shoot 20 pictures. Well, the flash is only going to do that, keep up with that for about 5 or 6, give or take. So, I mean, I can boom, 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 but I can still keep shooting pictures. Well, if you had, I'm sure there's technology out there that you guys are aware of, flashing, it doesn't necessarily have to be like this kind, where maybe it's not as powerful, but like, for example, a 2300 might be, what I'm saying is, if I had a 50mm lens, I mean, I realize that the flash isn't going to be as powerful as, you know, my 580 EX2, but for close-ups, or, you know, if I had a wide-angle lens and subjects that weren't too far away, I mean, that would be a great, you know, a great addition. You know, just a casual poo-poo with a smaller lens, maybe, for the casual photograph that can, you know, fill in, you know, have a fill flash effect, or just, you know, something to light up with enough light, that would be great. Realizing that most professionals aren't going to use it for their professional work, but every once in a while, a little bitty flash where people aren't too far away and subjects aren't too far away, that would be a great little feature, just to be able to boop, boop, boop. You know what I'm saying? Just I'm throwing it out. Now, having said that, that's pretty much it. So, with that in mind, Let me finish. What am I saying? This whatever this camera is going to be called, the 1D XS or the 1S or the 3D, the 46 megapixel behemoth, which is again rumored at $9,000. I'm sending my plea out to Canon that I want to test this thing. I want to be the one to unbox it, to put it through its paces, to just show all the stuff it can do, can do, go through all the manuals, make. Trust me, if you haven't seen my channel, you know I cover this stuff, okay? So I want to be the one to show the world, okay? I love your technology. It's time for this baby to be replaced. Not that it's not bad. This baby's still good. But there's so many things I could do if I had a, like I said, this only goes up to 1600. And there's a lot of things I'd like to be able to do with faster, more flash faster, better ISO, better sharpness. Obviously, this doesn't have, this autofocus has 5 autofocus points. Let's see, 1 in the middle, 2 in the, yeah, so 5 autofocus points. And obviously, that's anywhere near competing with what they got now. And that's with the 1DX and the 1DC. So I can only imagine this new thing's really, I would imagine, be even that good or better. So I want to unbox it, test it, show the world I'm all about, put it on my channel, help you guys out, and you guys can help me out at the same time. And it's a symbiotic relationship if you guys are Canon and able to help me out here. You know, you help me, I help you, because I want the camera, I want to use it, I want to own it, use it, and show the world all about it, and do a whole lot of stuff. And having said that, here's what I'm also wanting. I'm wanting the 28 to 300 millimeter lens, a filter, the 100 to 400 and a filter, the 50 millimeter standard with a filter. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, the fisheye. I don't think you have an extra filter for that because the lens is bulbous. But then I also need a macro lens, a 50 millimeter macro, so I can get, you know. So those are the lenses I want. If the GPS isn't internal, which I hope, cross my fingers it is. Then send me whatever little thing you got put on the side. But like I said, I'm hoping you guys are going to do that internal. And of course, the latest and greatest RT flash would be awesome. RT 600 flash would be awesome as well. I've got a 580EX, so you don't have to send me a flash, but that would be cool if you could send me the newer updated flash. But if that's not in your, I'm sure it's in your budget, but if you decide to do it. But I don't necessarily need that flash. I've got a good flash. But it would be great. I'm just saying. Of course, a case to put all this stuff in would be awesome as well. So that's what I'm wanting. That's what I'm asking. And again, I can't afford all that stuff right now. And I never could afford a $9,000 price point. I can't afford it. So I'm hoping that, like I said, you help me out. I'll help you out. And then by that, I'll have a great camera, a great system, and you guys will be able to, Canon will have, trust me, I'll be putting this stuff on Facebook, YouTube, Flickr, Facebook, Flickr, of course everything I put on Flickr and Facebook, or Flickr goes to my MySpace, YouTube, I mean the whole kit and caboodle, people have been tuning into my channel. Now there's people obviously with channels dealing with photography that, you know, get a lot more traffic, and that's because, well, especially the women out there that are doing photography, obviously they're better looking. And, anyway, you know who you are, Snap Chick. But, see, I can't compete with Snap Chick because she's hot. But anyway, she's real hot. Anyway, moving on. That's the idea that I'm offering to Canon. In fact, you know what, how serious I'm going to tell you my address. Not only is it on my YouTube channel, it'll be in the link in the description below, but I'm going to tell you right now, Canon Inc., if you want to help me out, my name, I'm the Canon EOS Photographer, Randall M. Rueff, Randall M., last name Rueff, Post Office Box 412, Taylorsville, Indiana, 47280-0412, in the good old U.S.A., I'm ready to review and use your new 46.1 megapixel camera and show and tell the world. So until next time, I'm Canon EOS Photographer Randall M. Rueff, saying thanks for watching, have a good day, and as always, may God bless you. Bye.